Hi, I'm Kevin O'Leary, and welcome to Kevin O'Leary's 180, the show that takes you halfway there and leaves the rest to your imagination. Today we're going to talk about Canadian entrepreneurs, and who better to focus on than the legendary Leonard Latchman. This man is known by everybody in Canada, known for his feats and successes on Bay Street that's left him a very wealthy man. But he doesn't keep it all for himself, he gives it away. Huge supporter for the Hospital for Sick Kids and the Center of Diversity. These are major focuses of Leonard's giving. But you know, Leonard's become a household name right across Canada. And I think the best way to capture what Canadians are thinking is let's take our cameras down to the streets and ask them about the legendary Leonard Latchman.
Captain Kirk's guy, Spock.
He's quite influential.
No idea. Is he related to Kevin O'Leary?
Leonard Latchman owes me $20.
I never heard of him.
He probably enjoys the limelight on TV.
Leonard Latchman?
I don't know any Leonard.
I don't know who Leonard Latchman is.
Who the is Leonard Latchman?
He's a people person.
I've heard he's world famous.
His music has been an inspiration to all humanity.
He's not been doing that great, I don't think, from a publicity perspective.
Who's Leonard Latchman?
I don't know anything about Leonard Latchman.
I absolutely know nothing about Leonard Latchman.
Yeah, we don't know. I'm sorry. We got to go catch a bus.
Yeah, bye.
I think he plays for the Raptors.
There's more!
Let's go live via satellite to Leonard Latchman.
Thank you, Kevin. Great to be here.
Leonard, every entrepreneur has his successes and his failures. How did you make your money?
I sold fans, ceiling fans, everywhere between Toronto and Oshawa. I used to make great sparkle hats, the black top hats at the CNE for all the concerts, Alice Cooper, Supertramp, and sold novelties at the X during the day every summer.
Making money is one thing. But what makes you a real entrepreneur is giving it back. What are your favorite charities?
Holtz, Harry Rosen, Nicholas Menswear. I love roaming around the Apple Store.
You're such a wonderful man. Leonard, I think every entrepreneur has a huge challenge in their life. It's the balance of the pursuit of wealth and time with your family. You've been able to put both together. You're a legendary family man. How do you do it?
Wake up in the morning, make some coffee, gotta have two or three cups, smoke a few cigarettes, read two or three newspapers, the three S's, get dressed, and start my meetings either at the office or around lunchtime downtown.
So Leonard, that's what you say, but let's grind right down to the truth and bring in your sister by satellite, Robin Latchman.
Hi, Kevin. Thanks for having me on the show.
Robin, everybody likes the PR of being a family man, but is it true?
Oh, definitely. Leonard was a great brother. I remember he used to play darts, and instead of having a dartboard, he used me as the dartboard.
Robin, thank you very much for that.
Oh, my pleasure, Kevin. I really appreciate you having me here.
Now, Leonard, you're the only guy I know over 50 that still smokes. What are your other hobbies?
Going to the gym, cooking, shopping, lunching, Manchu Wok, McDonald's, pizza.
Leonard, you're acting completely insane. Get a grip.
Muffins.
Let's bring in Pinball Clements by satellite live. Welcome, Pinball. Listen, besides all the drinking and the smoking, does Leonard have any other hobbies? You know him.
Thanks, Kevin. You know, it's always good to have a little background on where things come from and why they happen. Lynn was the guy. I was a rookie on the team trying to break into the roster, and he mentored me. He says, you know what, Michael, I'm going to move on over and I'm going to do some stuff in the financial industry here because I've got a lot of talents. He says, and you take over for me. He always kept partying, but he gave me my break. Leonard Latchman, where would I be without you?
Pinball, thank you very much for your time.
You're welcome, Kevin, anytime. Always there for you, buddy.
Leonard, in your younger days, you became a standard in adult movies. Every college dorm still sees you today. And yet, it never blossomed into a true Hollywood career. Let's find out why. Live by Skype, let's go to Perry Wolfman, legendary Hollywood agent. Perry?
Hi, Kevin. Nice to see you again. Thanks for having me.
You know, there were many tender moments in some of Latchman's earlier work on tape. Okay. Porn movies, but still tender. How come he never blossomed into a full-blown actor?
Actually, Kevin, when Leonard came to me with this opportunity, I told him I didn't think it was for him. You know what they say, big hands, big feet? Well, all Leonard had were big hands and big feet.
Perry, thank you very much. Keep Hollywood warm for us.
Thanks, Kevin. Thanks for having me.
After a long, industrious career, up, down, round and round, good, bad, and ugly, you're now receiving the Award of Merit at B'nai Brith. Why did it take so long?
It just depends what the market's looking for and the market itself, the securities markets at the time. Are you going to issue debt or are you going to issue equity? Is the market favoring technology or resource? So timing is very, very important.
Good answer, Leonard, but let's find out more from your confidant, Gene McBurney, chairman of GMP. I bet he has a few things to say. Gene?
Hi, Kevin. Thanks for having me on. Pleasure being here. The question is that you ask is an interesting one, but far more interesting is, why is he getting it at all? I find the whole thing a tad suspicious. You've got a guy with the name of McBurney and a guy by the name of O'Leary playing a very prominent role in this at a B'nai Brith event. Did I pronounce B'nai Brith right?
Leonard, besides a cigarette in the morning, what makes you get up? What makes you want to be alive? What's the love of your life?
Never a dull moment with Dane. Always, you know, one of the best joke tellers, always making everybody laugh, and an all-around great, great guy.
I'll tell you one quick story about Leonard's golf game. We're walking up the seventh hole in Weston, and he's had a tough day, and he goes, you know what, and he's mad, and he goes, Dane, you know what, some are left, some are right. I looked him in the eye, and I said, some are loving. Had me a blast.
Dane, great guy, but I'm trying to move you towards maybe a different kind of love in your life, maybe a woman. I've seen you walking around with somebody absolutely lovely. I think her name is Amanda?
Hi, Kevin. Thank you for having me today. Living with him, I've definitely learned a lot of daily lessons. For example, you must go to the washroom before you leave the house in the morning. Other than that, 4 newspapers are usually a good way to start your day. And never have lemon or lime with your Grey Goose. Just ice. Someone who knows Leonard even better than myself is his daughter, Billy Latchman.
Personally, I believe I should be receiving the Award of Merit. I'm brilliant. I'm smart. I'm beautiful. I'm funny. I'm very caring. I've planted a tree in Israel. I'm basically everything that my dad is, but so much more.
Now it's time for Kevin O'Leary's absolutely ridiculous list. And this week is a doozer. Here's the rumor. Leonard Latchman has 2 pandas caged up at his cottage in Muskoka, and he's been breeding them. According to sources, there's over 36 pandas. He's been able to do something no other government's been able to do, breed pandas. According to the Chinese, the male is named Cash, the female, Flo. It's fantastic. The problem is, what's Leonard doing with all these pandas? The Chinese government wants them destroyed because the market value of pandas is going to collapse when 36 new ones come on the market. And when I was talking to Amanda Lang about this CBC story that's emerging, she said, destroying pandas? Wait a second. What about a panda coat for me? I was stunned. I said, Amanda, these are young pandas, she said, exactly. Shocking and hopefully not true. This could devastate Leonard's legacy. Leonard, I hope you don't have those cash flow pandas up there. I can't remember a better show than the one we had tonight. The legendary life and times of Leonard Latchman. Join us next week. Oh, this just in. Oh, Kevin O'Leary 180 has just been canceled. I'm out of here.